that I draw for a living. And, you know, I've always draw. It's one of my favorite things. And I don't know if you remember when you were children and you're drawing, it's always great fun. You can always come up with great stories. Well, I moved on and went to the university. And while I was at the university, I learned that drawing comes from the right side of your brain. I read this amazing book written by Professor Betty Edwards, and it's called Drawing with the Right Side of the Brain. It means that, you know, our right side, our right hemisphere of the brain is responsible for perception. But usually it's the left side that takes over. So it's always trying to tell the right side what it's seeing. So drawing is seeing, but it's perceiving. Perceiving actually the things that we are seeing. And she also explains, and I think this is like really important, is that most of the times we see what we want to see. Our brain puts meaning into things that we are seeing, and we don't really see them at all. Now, in 2007, I went to Israel, and I went there on holidays, and I had a friend there. She let me stay on her place. I just finished a comic book about João Garcia, our Portuguese climber that went to Everest and many other high places. But I was in Israel, and being a workaholic as I am, I knew that being in a place without nothing to do would be very stressful. So I took a lot of my sketchbooks and I started drawing. And I was just drawing everything. I was in downtown Tel Aviv, and this was my friend's balcony, and this is the room where I was sleeping. Now, this is my friend with another friend, she's waxing her legs. And I was either her neighbors from across the street. And well, while I was there, I realized that, you know, this place had a lot of stories and meaning and things happening. But, you know, it didn't really relate to the idea that I had of Israel. Because, you know, we had this idea from the mass media, I think. And this was just life going on, people playing in bars, young people watching. And I suddenly realized that, you know, this is quite interesting. This, all these things going on. And this bottle of beer. And I suddenly started to think, okay, this is interesting for me. Perhaps it's interesting for other people. So maybe I can, with all these drawings, just tell a story and show something that people aren't aware of, like I was. So but even with this idea, I just, you know, I was on holiday, so I just kept drawing. I didn't really put a lot of effort into that. But when I got home, I scanned some of the drawings. This is one of them, and I colored them. And I did something that until then I hadn't really done, which was to use these drawings on my sketchbooks, and I would take pictures from the places I was drawing, and then color them in Photoshop, which is kind of a trick. It's a method, I like to think. And I was quite pleased with it. This was actually one of the first drawings that I did this, and, you know, it seemed quite okay. And I realized that, okay, I have all these bunch of drawings. I have all these bunch of photos. So, you know, perhaps I have something here. Show it to my publisher. She said, okay, you know, you have something there. Just go work and present this something. So I started to have this idea of a book of about Israel, about Tel Aviv, where I mostly had been. I was coloring the drawings. I was quite happy and pleased with the result and with this newfound method of coloring my drawings. But also I had a lot of drawings just from Tel Aviv and just mundane things like a juice stand or the view from my friend's balcony. And here is her again. I had a chance to visit Israel two more times. And these times I had the idea, okay, I'll do a book about Israel. So I have to travel a little bit more. And I show a little bit more of the country because it's not just Tel Aviv. So obviously I went to Jerusalem. And Jerusalem, of course, we have to visit the holy places. And you can't just draw one holy place. You have to draw all of them so people don't get angry. And this is the Wailing Wall. Before was the Dome of the Rock. I visiting these places was also quite surprising because you feel like, okay, you're in a holy place. But there, to me, there wasn't, this is the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and there wasn't much holiness there, I'm sorry. But it was just tourists, people just coming and going and taking pictures and visiting the place. And others were praying, of course. This is the entrance of the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and each tourist that was coming in was holding his camera high, and so were the priests. And again, it was these kind of things that I wanted to show and to talk about. When visiting other places, this is the Dead Sea, this is Masada, has this incredible story of the Romans sieging the place and everyone there committing suicide because they didn't want to be hostages. And then you're walking these places, you see these people and you're there and you read these stories and there's all this drama and it seemed like there was something there to tell. This is Sederot, which is the town next to the Gaza Strip. And I kept seeing these structures in the middle of squares. I didn't really knew what they were. They turned out to be shelters from the rockets coming up from the Gaza Strip. And I actually was, once I was in a shop buying something, and suddenly there's this alarm, which is just a woman saying red alert in Hebrew. And suddenly I see myself in this shelter with a lot of strange people. And we are really close by. And, you know, I look at someone and that person looked at me and for one second we thought, you know, you might be the last person I see. So that really shook me up a little bit to this broader view of the country and what I was seeing. But even then, and I went to this place where it's the border with Gaza, and you can see in the horizon it's the Gaza buildings. But I could only project in that place people and houses and kitchens and coffee places and children playing and women do the dinner. Somehow in these dramatic places comes these tourists of South American journalists who have a picnic there, quite relaxed, even though we were all a little bit jumpy when someone from a nearby base started to practice with a rifle. one of the last drawings I did. It's also one of the drawings that end the book, because I realized, you know, it's just all this experience was just about people, and even though there are people from one side, there are people from the other side, it's just people, and when you take the time and you look at people, they're just basically the same as you, same wishes, same fears, same wants. Now, obviously, this whole experience came out as a book, and I was quite pleased with this book, because it taught me again what I somehow had learned but forgotten about drawing, was it's just paying attention, and it requires discipline, it requires an effort, and you look at things, and sometimes just looking isn't enough, so you have to experience. Drawing certainly is a way of experiencing things, but just knowing this and having this perception that sometimes just looking isn't enough, because your brain is already putting meaning into the thing. Now, this was what I learned from this book. Now, almost a year after, I was invited to go to Kosovo, and I thought, how ironic. Going to Kosovo again was just this humbling experience of going to a place where you think you know everything and you don't know nothing, because it's really a beautiful place with beautiful people, very friendly, very nice, beautiful girls, by the way. And I call it newborn because of this immense, well, not immense, but monument that they have in Pristina, which was actually barbed wire before they became independent, because they were afraid that someone would damage them, the monument. And then someone realized that this wasn't the right way to celebrate our freedom, so just let people draw or write their names, whatever it is. And I do apologize for the advertisement. This is my last book. It's a comic book where I just try to put all these little things that I've learned ever since going to Israel. And it's just a celebration of small things, but friendship and traveling and cities and getting to know places. And it's what I have to offer you, and it's what I end this presentation. Thank you very much.